Hello, hello, and welcome to Cat's Treasure Hunting. I am Cat, and I am at an estate sale. I haven't been to one in a while. I saw this one on estatesales.net. They have tons of good stuff. The problem is, I have to be at the doctor in like an hour. So I have like 30 to 40 minutes here, and it looked like there's some good stuff. So let's go see what we can find. Oh, and there are already like 50 cars here, and they opened 1 minute ago. So this should be good. All right, so the sign said I could park past there since it was after 10, but I didn't know, so we got a little exercise. Now, walking up to the house, the whole porch was full of people waiting to get in, and there were already people inside, and this is 1 minute after the sale opened. So, not necessarily a great sign when I don't have very long because I have to be at the doctor, but I figure we'll go over here, check out the plants while we are waiting to hopefully get inside and have a little bit of time to look around. And it looks like most everything is priced, and I have this uncanny knack of finding stuff that is not priced. So I would love a couple more little banana trees in my yard, but the banana tree didn't have a price. I was so sad, so I didn't get it. All right, they are letting us in. And as you see, there are a lot of people here. And again, I got here at 1 minute after opening. Now, what I was so excited about in the preview was all of these cute little trinket boxes. There are so many of them. And I didn't see a price on them. I also didn't see a name. So I figured I would walk over and ask them how much. And I'm not familiar with this estate company. And she told me they were $14 each. And I guess it was written on one of them. And I'm not really used to companies doing that. So it was written on one that each of them were $14. But with no name on them, $14 is a lot. So I'm very, very sad because these were one of the biggest reasons that I wanted to come to the sale. And there was also an amazing swung vase that is gone. Apparently that was the first thing that was gone. Now, I am opening them because even though the other ones didn't have names, that doesn't mean the rest won't. But you can see here, this one had a $19.99 price tag and they have it at $14. And to me, that's just a little bit too high, even for an estate sale. I would have been happy to pay $5, and honestly, I would have took everything they had at $5. But at $14, it was just too much. Now, check out these amazing opera glasses. They're priced at $20. So at this point, I'm kind of worrying that I might not find anything. Now, this is Unicat Polish pottery, and it is amazing. If I collected things, this is exactly what I would collect because it's got the awesome sea life on it, the starfish, the shell, the turtles. It is an amazing print, but $10 for the plate, just a little too much for me. I probably would have paid about $5. I couldn't really find that many with that pattern, just of note. So it might have been worth the $10. And if you know, definitely let me know. So you can see there's tons of Christmas. It does not appear to be any vintage Christmas to me, which is typically what I look for. And the sheets all seem like they are newer as well. The prices are not horrible on the sheet sets, but I typically want vintage. Now, you can see there's a t-shirt guy, so I got to that closet probably about 2 minutes too late. But we're still gonna look. Now, the stockings, again, they are not vintage. They have them at $7. So a lot of this is just, it's great stuff. It's just more than I can pay realistically reselling. Now, I probably should have checked these two jackets a little better. This one on the left is a motorfish jacket. This was probably worth it, and I think they had it at 30, and that was a major miss by me. Now we're in the closet, literally. We are in the closet. And the only thing that sucks at estate sales like this is only one person can be in there. And like, I had to wait to get in here, and then there were other people waiting behind me to get in here. So I feel rushed when I am in that situation. So I did find these two Marines hats. I like those. There's also a Columbia shirt. Now, this brand I wasn't familiar with, and I think I'm gonna find another one and I'm gonna grab it, but they don't sell as well as Columbia. And it's so hard in here. Digital camo, that's what they're called. I couldn't remember. They're digital camo. So I'm trying to look. I found this is a really awesome Tommy Bahama t-shirt. The other thing about all of this is they don't have it priced. So they say shirts are between $5 and $10, and they just price it when you get there, which I don't really like, but I think I did get those two for only $5. However, I could have got up there and they were 10, and then you're kind of in a sticky situation because you feel bad because you grabbed them. I missed, if you see that polo, if you see that polo, there was a blue Gators Nike polo there that I passed over that I saw somebody grabbing and checking out with after me. And I was like, man, because I'm just trying to go fast in here to let other people. Coolabar, that was the brand. I grabbed it, should not have grabbed it. So it's really hard at estate sales when you feel a little rushed, and here I didn't have the best signal. I couldn't look stuff up. I did grab that Wrangler jacket, but I kind of felt pressured because I know when I'm waiting, I don't want the person in front of me to take forever. So I'm trying not to take forever in this closet. And this house, if you see as I'm walking through it, there is not much navigating space. So it's very tight quarters in here. I think that's why they were only letting so many people in at a time. Now, I was looking to see if that hat was maybe a Columbia hat, but it was not. So we're gonna get out of this closet and let somebody else get in there. And we're gonna go check out this bathroom. Guys, do not pass over bathrooms when you're at estate sales. There can be a lot of things that are worth money in bathrooms. Now, granted, I did not find any bathroom stuff in this bathroom, but vintage colognes, perfume bottles, things like that, keep an eye out for. This is a vintage Levi's buckle for $2. I did grab that. And look what is hanging in the back of the bathroom. A Harley Davidson mesh thick jacket. It was priced at $30, and this one I think is going to be worth well over $100. So we are definitely going to add that to our pile. And also here hanging up, look at all these towels. What does one do with all of those towels? I have a lot of towels, but I don't have that many towels. All right, so this Columbia jacket is a really thick winter jacket. It is a size large. It was $20. I did get it. I think that was a good buy. Now, here are more of the little trinket dishes. So another price tag of $25. Again, they have them all at $14, and I just cannot do it. Now, I did empty my hands. That lovely lady was writing my name down for my pile, so we are empty-handed again as we head towards the kitchen and the back of the house. And again, on the tree, pretty much all newer stuff. I'm not seeing a lot of vintage in here, which is okay. There is still stuff to be found, but that is primarily what I look for. I am not sure what this was, but it was $12, which was just a little more than I would pay, especially with no name. Now we're gonna squeeze here, literally, into the kitchen and see what we see. I did see a La Crusade, and I don't know if I'm saying that right, That was in the hold area. Somebody grabbed it. Now, this is a Pier 1 Imports. They have it priced at 10. It only sells for about 15 on eBay. So when you're looking for stuff for a profit, you've got two things. First, you have to find the stuff, and then the stuff has to be priced low enough that you can make a profit on it. So don't go getting all excited that you find good brands or good things, because if you pay too much, it doesn't matter. So they have a bunch of jewelry, but nothing that interested me. Never pass up a bathroom. Do not pass up a bathroom. I again, though, am coming up empty-handed. You can see here me in the mirror, and I have this really cool new thing that I saw Marsha Red Cardinal Treasures use, and it's actually a necklace with a magnet, and my camera is attached, so it looks like it's just stuck to my shirt. It's pretty cool. This was the first time I used it, and I was happy with it. We're gonna squeeze again, and I'm not a fan of squeezing. All right, again, newer stuff, but some really cool stuff. I love how they have this house decorated. I do love this little pottery turtle, and I think he was a little handmade pottery turtle. So I am gonna pick him up and check out this hand-painted mermaid art. It is on wood, and that was cool. The big mermaid was $150, so we're gonna leave her there. That was just a little cheap art glass. That one was not a good one. The little stingrays are cute. Now, look at this, and I will tell you. This is Jeremy Diller Raku Pottery, and those sell for about 15, but I collect them, so I'm going to keep that one. And they sell for between 13 and 17 for those little Raku coins. Now, here, these are really nice. This is a nice little fossil checkbook wallet, but they had it at $10. So again, great stuff at this estate sale. Price is a little too high for a reseller. If you're buying for yourself, the prices would be excellent. And you saw the t-shirt guy got to that closet before me again. I was too late again. Now, these are little millefiori flower, little glass hearts for three. I am gonna get those. And here is another really cool Raku coin. Again, I only know those because I collect them. They are Jeremy Diller Raku pottery. And we're going to try and get in this closet. But knowing that he had already dug through here, I didn't have very high hopes. However, there's this really cool pair of workout pants. And I've been going to the gym 5 days a week. So I think I'm going to get these pants for me. I like being loud. If you do not know me. So, I think these will stand out nice at the gym, and we are going to pick them up for me. And we will dig a little bit. I don't have a ton of time. Normally, I would probably move these to the bed to go through them a little better, like so I could set everything out. But again, I'm on a super limited time crunch here because I have to get to the doctor. So I'm just kind of looking through the top, and again, he had just went through here, and it was very obvious he was a t-shirt guy. There are t-shirt guys. Now, what I do notice here in this back tote is that most of these were like for charity events. You can see here, this was a cystic fibrosis. And those typically do not sell as well as just a regular sports team or a sporting event or game. So let's see what else is on the little nightstand. I think I'm giving up on the t-shirt. Look at this amazing crushed glass. I love these. It is made in the USA. So I think we're going to take stuff out of it, and we're going to get the heart dish that was holding all of the stuff. I absolutely love crushed glass pottery, and we're going to take this. And another item not priced, so a little bit scary. And we're going to go into this last room real quick and see what we can see in here. this person was very obviously a big NHRA drag racing fan, as well as a Florida Gators fan. There was tons of autographed football stuff. And I know the Tebow jersey that was signed, that was framed, was like $500. So I didn't look any of those up. I do like that hat, and I am going to grab it. And you will see everything I got at the end of this for a haul. I didn't get a bunch of these NHRAs. They were from 2018, so they're only 5 years old. I typically, again, like to find the older ones unless they're like a really cool pattern like that one that I did pick up. And I see some Gator hats here in the corner as well. So we will take a look and see. And it looks like you can see that one was stained on the inside, but he kept them stored very nicely. Now, this one's a really, really nice one, and I'm going to get this. Dalton might want to keep this. I am not sure. If he doesn't, it will probably sell for about $15 to $20. And I wish I had time to look through these banners. I have sold some banners for incredibly good money, and they only wanted $20 a banner. I just do not have the time to look through all the banners today, unfortunately. And there is a Titleist hat. It almost, I don't know who signed it. So we will leave it. Now here are Florida Gators Harley Davidson. I actually have sold this exact hat. So I'm going to pick this one up. That second one is a little faded and has more stains. So we're going to leave that one there. And we'll see if we see anything on the shelves. Again, most of this is relatively new stuff, not a bunch of older stuff. These Remington cards look really cool. They didn't have a price. I ended up paying $5 for them. I didn't expect them to be that much. They sell for about $15, so I'm not going to lose money, but I would have liked to be more around the $2 to $3 mark on those. And I need a calculator for my desk. So we're going to see, because $3 is cheaper. I guess I could get a dollar store one, but I don't know. And I always check them. This one here won't turn on, so we're definitely not getting that one. I think I'll get this big one because I want one to sit on my desk at home. And we'll see what else. This box in the back is kind of catching my eye. Really cool carved wood and hand-painted with the celestial sun. Really, really cool box. It looks like it was originally $18. They had it priced at $10. Again, something I probably want to pay like, oh no, they added it $12. I would probably want to pay about $5 to $7 for that. So I would be better getting there on the last day when I could get half off. But we'll see what else we see. Now, here is a really cool Cloisonné magnifying glass. They only have this one priced at $4, which I think is a great price. So there's always going to be some stuff, even if most of the stuff is overpriced. And these stickers, I think, all look like they're pretty new. So we're going to pass those by as well. And we're going to head to check out. And in line, I saw this really cool carved gators. This is at NCAA. Really cool carving. So I'm going to pick that up. We're going to go wait in line and check out. And I will be right back with you here in just a second. All right. We got some good stuff. The stuff I really wanted was priced too high. I just could not do it. But I might go back the third day. It really sucks because the fourth day we're going out on the boat. So I can't go the last day and try and get really, really good deals. But I might go back Saturday because I asked if they would make a deal on all the trinket boxes. I really, really like them, but $14 is just way too much. But we did get some good stuff. I'm going to run into the doctors. I'm at the doctors now. And I'll be right back and take a look at everything we got.
All right, so a lot of stuff there was priced more than I wanted to pay. I got these leggings for me. I've been going to the gym, so I'm gonna use those. I love the crackle glass pottery. It's made in the USA. This one is a really, really pretty one. And then I actually collect Raku, which this is, I believe, Jeremy Diller Raku. This one says, "I am courage." And then the little dolphin one, which I don't have either of these, says, "I am playful." So those two I'm going to keep. And then I got this cool little turtle. I paid three for him, two Murano hearts for three each. I thought this was pretty cool with the painted mermaid as I drop it. And then the Florida Gators wood. I thought it was really cool. I don't know if I'll keep that or not. And then Cloisonné magnifying glass. I think this is a vintage Levi's belt buckle for two. I got four hats. I got the Gators hat, the NHRA Gator Nationals. So there were two Harley Gator hats there. The other one was really, really bad condition. This one has a little bit of staining here, but we will just notate that. But the other one was faded and had the staining. I got the Marines. The Harley jacket is probably either the Harley jacket or the Columbia. One of these two are probably going to be the best buy. I paid 30 for this Harley jacket, and it is a size extra large. The Columbia, I paid 20, and then I got this Coolabar. I didn't know this brand. It actually doesn't sell well, so I probably won't pick up any of these again. Got the Columbia men's extra large, the Tommy Bahama t-shirt, and this Wrangler we will have to research and see. This one might be decent too. I think she charged me 10 for this one, but I think that could be a good buy. So if stuff was priced lower, there was a lot there I liked, but with the prices, this is all we got. So if there's anything you're interested in, definitely let me know. You can email me thenurseflipper@yahoo.com, and I will see you on the next one. Also, a lot of you have been asking about our Ready Kilowatt back here. He is vintage from the 1960s. I think I have him priced around $200-$250. Just an FYI, his hand is broken there and part of his head. If he was not broken, he would be worth probably about $600-$700. So if you find them in any way, shape, or form, definitely pick those up. And yeah, thank you for watching.